So, Jim, we last saw you in September over in Jordan. You flew halfway across the world, had a great fight, got a great win. When you look back at that show, what are your main memories and recollections?
I just remember being excited to go to Jordan, experience the culture and everything. The fight right now, it's always a blur, you know. I go in there with a whole game plan, but when I throw that first punch, everything goes out the window, you know. Just how he reacts to it, and then I go from there. So I can't really explain the fight unless I'm watching it.
Fair enough. So that was 7 months ago. What have you been doing to keep busy and keep yourself occupied since then?
I always compete in jiu-jitsu tournaments, like I said. I received my brown belt finally in jiu-jitsu after 4.5 years being a purple belt. So I was competing in those. I've been doing a lot of boxing lately also, you know. I don't want to just focus on jiu-jitsu. I want to focus on my weaknesses as well. I've been to Duke Rufus's camp to work on Muay Thai also, so I want to be a complete well-rounded fighter, not just a one-rounded kind of guy.
Do you think it's important for MMA fighters to stay active in that way between fights, not just training but competing in grappling tournaments and boxing tournaments, etc.?
Yeah, I think it keeps you very sharp, you know, like if you're just doing MMA, it could get stale also, so I like to compete in anything I can, you know. If someone tells me, like, let's do a domino tournament, I'll do a domino tournament if I had to, you know. Just different things, you know, it just keeps my mind sharp.
As you said, and as we've seen, you know, you're often talking about competing and staying active between fights in that way. Has that competitive edge always been there for you from an early age?
Yeah, as long as I can remember, I know I had two older brothers growing up, so competition is just in our family a lot. And, I mean, I've done all kinds of sports growing up, so yeah, I think I've been competitive my whole life.
I saw you on Twitter recently answering some fan questions, and one of the things you said you liked about Cage Warriors was the opportunities you've had to travel all over the world. Obviously, you've not had much chance to see Scotland yet, but what's your favourite place you've been so far?
So far, after Jordan, we went to Lebanon and Beirut, and I thought, you know, that place was just very beautiful, and saw the culture there. It's something you don't see in America. It was very culture shock, and just the way they lived and everything there was amazing, you know. And I'm excited that I still get to see lots of the world, and excited to see Glasgow and see what it's about here.
We've just seen Conor McGregor debut in the UFC, obviously a former Cage Warriors featherweight champion and lightweight champion. Jim, you were supposed to fight Conor on a number of occasions. Has there ever been a sort of sense from you that that was maybe your opportunity and that could have been your shot?
No, I mean, I'm never wishing wrong on people, you know. I want everyone to do well, you know. It's all part of fighting, you know. Everyone gets their chance, and I'm excited that he got his chance. I'm excited it's a Cage Warriors vet, you know, to be there representing, you know. Like I said, I tell people it was never about fighting him, you know. I've always just wanted the title, and whoever had the title I was going to fight. So, you know, I'm very happy for him. You know, I'm a fan. I want to see him do well, you know. I'm never going to wish him bad in the UFC.
So, Jim, now you're fighting for that belt that Conor McGregor held. Do you now feel that this is your time and this belt can do for your career what it's done for Conor's?
Oh, yes. I mean, Cage Warriors propels people's careers so far. So many UFC fighters have come after being Cage Warriors champions, you know, and I feel like this after this step, you know, I should be right there with him.
So, another big thank you, Jim, since we last saw you. A bit of big news in your personal life. You're going to be a father. Congratulations. And how's that changed things for you, and how do you see it changing things in the future?
I just feel now, you know, I have something else to fight for, you know. I'm not just fighting for myself. I'm fighting for the future of my family, and there's so much more to it, you know. It's like, it's not all about just about me, and now I need to make time for my wife, you know, make time for those extra doctor appointments, you know. I need to be there. I want to be like the best father I could possibly be. So when I fight, you know, I'm fighting for a better future for my family.
As we've said, Jim, you're about to fight for the Cage Warriors featherweight title. Considering, you know, all the stuff you've got going on at home at the moment, what does it mean to you to take that belt back to your friends, to your family now?
Yeah, to fight for this world title means so much to me, and especially to bring it back to the States, to my own students, you know, my family. I just, you know, I want to make them proud, you know. I have my own MMA team that I built now from the ground up, and for me to come back with a title would just, you know, be so big for them.
Obviously, you know, this is the short term, this is the here and now, but how about the next 5 years? What are some of your ambitions, Jim, both inside the cage as a fighter and outside of it as a person?
The same. Of course, every fighter's goal, I feel, is to make it to that big show, you know? And like I said, being in Cage Warriors helps a lot. I've seen it happen. And, you know, in the future, I want to build fighters. Like I said, right now I've built my own MMA team over at Alliance from the ground up, and we have an amazing record, something like 16-2 in our last 18 fights. So I'm excited to be a part of that and see my students grow from what I'm teaching them. And hopefully everything I learn, I can just give over to them to make them as successful as I've become.